Why is Salesforce doing this and why now?
So big picture, Salesforce has been a pioneer in AI for over a decade. We created Einstein, which brought everyone to have their own data scientists about a decade ago. And now today, we're delivering over a trillion predictions every week for all of our hundreds of thousands of customers, which brought them into AI. And now we've moved from predictive to generative. And Salesforce, who has led every seismic shift in technology from going to cloud to mobile to social, we are here right at the forefront, leading all of our customers into generative AI with Tableau GPT and Tableau Pulse.
So Sarah, you're out at the Tableau conference. The other tool announced is Slack GPT. So the question is this you trying to get Salesforce customers to use the services of other things you've acquired in recent years?
So Salesforce, we have an incredible suite across the entire customer 360. Sales, service, marketing, commerce. Slack has been an incredible addition to our portfolio, helping everyone have great, productive employees. And we ask ourselves the question, how do you make every employee more productive? How do you make every customer more happy? How do you provide incredible customer service and sales and marketing and a fully integrated single source of truth of your customers? And so yes, by providing that entire suite of products for our customers, they can all have better customers and better employees. And it's really important that we give them all of their data so they can unlock it and really have that trusted customer and company data to use generative AI and to have Tableau GPT really bring that data to life for everyone that's involved in customer engagement.
Caroline, data is really the key point, isn't it? Particularly when we're talking about enterprise as a use case for generative AI tools, there's an element of concern about the data, its sourcing and how it's secure.
Yeah, and Sarah, to that point, you used trusted a number of times there, or single source of truth. Is there any concern that generative AI does just make some things up? If there is a hole in the private data that this is being run on, the so-called hallucinations, and many people take issue with that particular turn of phrase, but is that happening? How do you ensure that people are getting the right insights at the right time?
Trust is absolutely paramount, as we've discussed just now. Every company wants to have trusted data. They need to know that they have their data is being trusted. Their customers expect them to trust them with their data. And Salesforce, at our core, we have always had trust as our number one value. And so having trusted data is important because your AI is only as good as your data. And so no company wants to bring hallucinations, as you say, into the enterprise. They need to know that they can trust the AI. And that's why our approach is founded on trust. And we always have a human in the process because the AI is here to help us, not to replace us. And so that's so important that the data is trusted so that you can also trust the generative AI that's being created from that data.
Interesting. So I'm feeling that you're on the AI is here to augment us humans rather than take away our jobs. But you are someone who's built your career on sort of the democratization of technology. You're someone who's deeply passionate about how with ease people can change from a blue collar job to a white collar job using, for example, the ways in which you've used trailheading, for example. But are you broader picture here thinking AI is going to inevitably take white collar jobs at the moment?
So I really want to look at generative AI as an incredible opportunity for us. It's really interesting when you rewind back in history and you think of the first computer. The first computer was a person, not a machine. And there was a lot of fear that it would replace us in our jobs. Fast forward to today, we don't have enough skilled talent for all of the jobs that work with computers and work in tech. And so we're already seeing new careers being created, such as prompt engineering or AI illustrations. There's a lot of opportunity. So we, as an industry and as Salesforce, we do take it as our responsibility to skill people up for the future. We created Trailhead as a free online learning platform to democratize all of this technology so everyone can have access and everyone can learn. There's incredible opportunity, and we want to make it easy and accessible for everyone. And we can also hopefully change the ratios in tech in the process. But yes, we are here to help skill people up and help remove the fear from this incredible new generation of technology we see with generative AI.
Sarah, how are these new tools driving sales for Salesforce?
So generative AI is everything that all of our customers are talking about. They are wondering how to future-proof their business in the wake of this new technology trend. And it's here to stay. It's not a fad. And so every single one of our customers is looking to Salesforce right now and saying, we trust you. We know that you will guide us into this future, just like you guided us into cloud, into mobile, into social. And so, yes, every single one of our customers wants Salesforce GPT to help them with sales GPT, service GPT, marketing GPT, and more. And Tableau GPT and Tableau Pulse are incredible innovations that are going to help fuel all of our customers' success.
In your career, as Caroline pointed out, you've been through waves of new technological advancement. This has happened quite quickly. Did Salesforce really plan these tools over a really long period of time, or is this something that you've rushed through in recent weeks in response to what the rest of the industry's done?
So this is what's so powerful, is that Salesforce has been a pioneer in AI. For over a decade, we've been investing in Einstein, which is our AI platform. And we have seen, as I mentioned earlier, we have over 1 trillion predictions being done every single week on our AI platform. So this is not something that we're just pulling out of a hat. We have been investing in this for a long time, and we have the world's best data scientists that are here at Salesforce, and they're generating all kinds of incredible large language models that help us create code, that help us create reply response, that help us create great engagement and ways for, like you see with Tableau GPT and Tableau Pulse, for people to really bring their data to life, where in the past they haven't been able to really do that easily. So this has been something Salesforce has been doing for a long time and will continue to be a leader in generative AI.
A leader at a time where the macro headwinds for every single industry are tough at the moment. And Sarah, as you talk about the in-house talent that you have to keep building, it's at a time where we know companies like yours are having to lay off staff, having to slim down in the face of what has been a slowing economy. Have you got the right mix of talent at the moment, do you think?
At Salesforce, we have the most talented engineers, marketeers, salespeople. We have the best people in the business at Salesforce. And we are more equipped than ever. Our company is in a great spot set up for the decades to come. We're laser focused on our customers, on our innovation, and really delivering success for everyone.